This is a breaking news alert.
Got some more amazing video we're going to show you in a moment. Yes, this morning, Donald Trump said the one thing that Comey and Hillary did not want getting out. Paris Wade, Liberty Writers, gives us the background. President Trump slammed the rigged system following the twisted reports that the former FBI Director James Comey began drafting an exoneration statement for Hillary Clinton before he had ever interviewed her, according to Fox News. Here's the tweet that our president put out. Wow, looks like James Comey exonerated Hillary Clinton long before the investigation was over. And so much more. A rigged system. My friends, this is the scandal of the century. And where is liberal media? Oh, they're still running cover for the Clintons, yes. The president, what he's talking about there, specifically about the allegations made yesterday by the Senate Judiciary Committee Chairman Chuck Grassley and Senator Lindsey Graham. Okay, we covered that yesterday. So where's the media? Okay, where are they? They covered play-by-play the Russian conspiracy theory against Trump every single day. But they haven't even bothered to touch this one. They're nowhere to be found. Except, however, one of my favorite journalists, Tucker Carlson. Take a look.
It's incredible. It shows the investigation truly was a sham. You know, Comey came out and said, well, he made the decision in July. Well, his deputies were interviewed by government officials, and they said, well, he began drafting the statement in early May, maybe even early as April, before they had interviewed 17 key witnesses, including Clinton. And remember, they gave immunity to all those witnesses, and everyone was outraged. And now we know why they gave immunity, because they weren't going to prosecute anybody. Why get in the way? Why let testimony or grand juries get in the way of this sham investigation? Just give everyone immunity and just proceed.
A Potemkin investigation. I'm really fascinated by this part of the story, which I can hardly believe is true. There's evidence apparently that the FBI helped pay for the dossier on Donald Trump, the Russian dossier that was published ultimately in BuzzFeed. Can that be right?
That's right. They started paying, it looks like, the expert behind the dodgy dossier.
During the campaign.
Right, during the campaign.
The FBI helped pay for Oppo research on Hillary's opponent.
That's right. And the firm evidently...
Do we know that's true?
Well, we're trying to get answers about that. And we asked the FBI for documents about any payments they made to the author of the Trump-Russia dossier. And they came back to us and they said, we can't even confirm or deny whether any such documents exist. So I don't know who's running the FBI. Well, I do. But it's certainly not someone with the interests of the American people in terms of getting some transparency about the misconduct of the FBI during the Obama administration as they were working to really nail Trump through this really awkward and, let's put it this way, conspiratorial relationship with the authors of the Trump dossier.
Well, if that's true, you hear all this barking about fascism, fascism's coming to America. You know, it's armed organizations like the FBI, for which I have respect. But if it turns out they're this corrupt, you know, this is stuff you should worry about.
This is a twofer story. You've got Comey protecting Hillary Clinton while targeting Trump at the same time. That's the intervention in the election we need to be investigating. And if I were President Trump, I'd order the DOJ to do an audit of what the FBI and Justice Department were up to last year, including reviewing the handling of the Clinton investigations, and yes, the handling of his investigations as well. He's a victim here, but the American people are too, because they were abusing the political process even more so than any Russians were.
Well, I don't even want to believe that, but I'm shocked by it. Thank you, Tom, for that.
You're welcome, Tucker.
God, I love Tucker Carlson. Of course, there was Tom Fitton again. You saw him in our last report. That was from the previous report was from the Judicial Watch YouTube channel. I encourage you to go there, too. But you understand what's happening here. He said, conclusion first, fact gathering second. That's no way to run an investigation. Chuck Grassley and Graham wrote in a letter to the FBI this week that, quote, the FBI should be held to a higher standard, especially in a matter of such great public interest and controversy. Quote, according to the unredacted portions of the transcript, it appears that in April or early May of 2016, Comey had already decided he would issue a statement exonerating Secretary Clinton. The words of the senators. Okay, so this is, my friends, the scandal of the century and needs to be out there. Everybody in America need to know what's going on. Okay, Republican friends, Democrat friends, whatever. Okay, this is not going to get the coverage it deserves. You think CNN and MSNBC, they're going to be, you know, running this story day and night? No, they're not. So the Democrats are going to cover this up and no one's going to hear it, the other half of America. So it's up to us. We're doing our part. We hope you will too. Share this with a Democrat friend so that we can get this word out there, okay? The entire cabal is covering up the story. It's not going to get the traction, okay? Facebook will probably suppress it. CNN's not going to cover it, right? So it's up to us, literally, to share this everywhere and bring down the crime syndicate that runs our government. Leave your comments below. Subscribe for updates. If you like what we're doing, give us a thumbs up and share this report on your social networks. For the Next News Network, I'm Gary Franchi.
Badass shirt now available. Link in the description.
You possess the power to impact the global narrative. Please share this report, and to get more videos like this, become a Next News subscriber by clicking the link below. Thank you for watching the Next News Network.